Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over breakout rooms inside of Microsoft Teams. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. What is a breakout room, you might be asking? Well, a breakout room is a way for larger meetings to have a separate space for smaller groups of people to meet together while the meeting is going on. So you could think of this in a couple different ways. If you were teaching a class, maybe you want a few students to partner up and be able to go and discuss some ideas for a project or a presentation or something like that for the class. Or maybe you have a large meeting and you would like to break people up by departments to discuss some of the ideas that were just being taught and then come back into a larger group and present those ideas. Or maybe you would just like to break people up for a quick brainstorming session for 5 or 10 minutes. So that would be a good reason to use a breakout room. I would like to note that the Microsoft Teams breakout rooms are not available on the free version of Microsoft Teams, but rather it's the version that comes with your subscription to Microsoft 365. So in case you're trying to follow along with the free version and you don't see the option for breakout rooms, that's why. So let me show you how this works. Here is a Teams meeting that I have already begun. I have a couple people who have joined this meeting, and we are at a point in our meeting where we would like to go into separate rooms. So right here on this icon that says Rooms, I'm going to click on that, and I now have some options here. I can either automatically assign people to a breakout room, or I can manually choose people that I want to put in each room. So for now, I'm just going to do the automatic assignment and hit Create Rooms. If I look over here, I can see that each person in my meeting has been put into a separate breakout room. And if I click on the room, I will see who is inside that breakout room. And if I click on this room, I can see who's inside that breakout room as well. I can also go to this room and hit this Delete button, and I'm able to remove the breakout rooms. So if I go back to Rooms, and this time if I choose to manually assign people to the rooms, I can hit Create Rooms. And I can click the unassigned here and assign a different room for different people in their breakout rooms. Right here, I only have two people, but you can sort of see where this would go if you had more than two other people inside of your Teams meeting. So I've put my attendees into different rooms and I'm just going to hit assign. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And now you can see people inside of their breakout rooms. And I can open a breakout room. So if I would like to go into here, I can just hit Join Room. And you can see I am now inside one of the breakout rooms. And back here behind the scenes, you can see the main meeting over here. So if I hit Leave on the breakout room, I am only leaving this breakout room. I can also rename my breakout room by clicking these three dots and going to Rename. And I can also close the breakout room. If I click this plus here, I can add another breakout room. And you can see that that's been named Room 3 by default. I can also hit this button to make an announcement. And this is a text announcement. So if I would like to say, hope you have some good ideas, and if I hit send, and I open this breakout room, and I join this breakout room, if I go over to the chat, I can see my announcement has come through. And not only that, but it's been marked as important. So this would be a good way to maybe give a 5-minute warning that you want everyone to come back to your meeting. So I'm going to close this breakout room. I can also hit this button over here, and I can set some settings for my breakout rooms. I can turn on the time limits. Maybe I want my breakout rooms only to last about 15 minutes. I can let people decide to leave their breakout room and return to the main meeting. And I can also assign different presenters to manage the different breakout rooms if I would like to do that. So I'm going to return back to my breakout room. And then if I go and delete all of my breakout rooms, and I go up here and hit resume, I can see that everyone has returned to the meeting. I do know I lost one of the people in my meeting just now because they needed to use their computer. Hopefully that gives you a good overview on your options when it comes to creating breakout rooms inside of Microsoft Teams. Hope you have a chance to use this in the future and look forward to seeing you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.